Let us now try to develop a pseudocode to determine if a given input year is a leap year or not. So say for example, our assumption generally is we believe that every year or any year when it is divided by 4, if the remainder happens to be 0, that is a leap year. That understanding is not really correct. The logic for the leap year is quite different in reality. Now suppose what actually happens in a leap year is every year we have about close to 6 hours, a little less than 6 hours extra. So at the end of 4 years, we turn that 4th year into a leap year. This way normally every 4th year happens to be a leap year. But in case of century years, there is a different rule. If a century year is divisible by 400 and then there is no remainder, that's a leap year. So not every century year like 1700, 1800, 1900 is a leap year. There is a reason for this. Because if you remember earlier I told you, we are not considering it as exact time. We are considering the actual extra hours per year is little less than 6. Since it's a little less than 6, we have overcompensated or we have overcorrected. In order to adjust this overcorrection or overcompensation, we do not treat years like 1700, 1800, 1900 as leap years. Only years like 2000, 1600, which are divisible by 400, and after dividing by 400, if the remainder happens to be 0, then we treat them as a leap year. So let's try to understand this particular logic. So first is, if I have to calculate a leap year, I need to have a variable called as year. I need to ask the user to enter some year into the variable called as year. So this is my first statement. So I have a variable called as year. I am asking the user to enter a value into the year. Now once he enters the value into the year, the logic for leap year has to go in a particular order. I need to first check for all those century years which are perfectly divisible by 400, like 2000, 1600, etc. So what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to ask a question. If the given year is perfectly divisible by 400, that means when the input year after dividing by 400, if the remainder happens to be 0, I'll straight away say that's a leap year. Now the next thing I'll do is, I will worry about century years like 1700, 1800, 1900. So for any other century year, on division by 100, if the remainder happens to be 0, then that particular year is not a leap year. So this is what I am going to write here. Okay, here it is. So else if the year is perfectly divisible by 100, then it's not a leap year. Now we have taken care of all century years. Now we'll have to take care of non-century years. For non-century years, the logic is pretty clear. If the given year on dividing by 4, if the remainder is 0, it's a leap year, else it's not a leap year. So the first question I'm going to ask is, if the year is perfectly divisible by 4, then display it as a leap year. Else, for any non-century year which is not divisible by 4, display it as not a leap year. In order to understand the working of this flowchart, to understand the working of this pseudocode, the best way is to run through certain number of years. So let's take the year 2000 to start with. So when I read a year, year is 2000. So when I divide year by 400, as in this case, 2000 by 400, it happens to have a remainder of 0. Because of that, since this condition happens to be true, I am going to print leap year. And I am going to come out and stop here. Let's look at now a year like 2020. So I read a value into the year. Year is 2020. Now, is 2020 divided by 400, what is the remainder? Remainder is going to be 20. So this condition is false. Now, I come to the else if part. Now, 2020 divided by 100, the remainder is still going to be 20. So this condition is also false. I come here. Now, 2020 divided by 4 has to have a remainder of 0. Then, automatically, I'm going to print leap year and I'm going to come here. Now let's take one odd case of 2022 or 2023, that's better. If we take 2023 divided by 400, the remainder is going to be 23, so this condition is false. I'm going to come here, 2023 divided by 100, the remainder is again going to be 23, So again, this condition is false. It is not zero. So here, 2023 divided by 4, the remainder is going to remain half 3. 3 is not equal to 0. So I am going to come to the else part and I am saying it's not a leap year. So the concept for this if else is like this. If the first condition happens to be true, as in the case of the year 200, then I will print leap year and I will not go through the other else if and else. If the first condition happens to be false, then I'll only go to the next condition. As an example of 2023, when each of this condition was false, then I only went to the else part. So in a nutshell, at the position where the condition happens to be true, it will come out of the if then and it will come here. If this condition only happens to be false, it will keep checking for some condition to be true. If none of the conditions are true, automatically the else has to be true and it's going to show it as a not a leap year. Now let's look for 1700 and 1800. Let's say 1700. 1700, if you divide by 400, the remainder is going to be 100. 100 is not equal to 0. That means it's not perfectly divisible by 400. Now I come here, 1700 divided by 100, the remainder is going to be 0. But any century year which is not a multiple of 400, I have to say it's not a leap year. So this is the pseudocode to determine if a given input year is a leap year or not. So I recommend you to take different years as per your choice and run through this pseudocode logic to determine if a given input year is a leap year or not.